The unemployment rate is a magic monthly number that economists, politicians, and journalists love to obsess over. It's one of the most closely watched economic indicators, but it's far from the last word on jobs. Sure, it measures how many people in the workforce didn't have a job last month, but the workforce only includes people who have a job or are actively looking for work. So if you're tired of looking for work and you've given up the hunt, you won't get counted even though you're still unemployed. To get the bigger picture, economists turn to the long-term unemployment rate. Well, not that far back. If you've been out of work for 6 months or more and you're still actively looking for work, this number applies to you. It's a subset of the bigger unemployment number, and it's basically a measure of how tough it is to find a new job. Now, let's say you have a part-time job even though you want to work full-time. That's yet another indicator. And there's a separate measure of how many adults are working or actively applying for jobs. That's the labor force participation rate. Okay, so what's the real unemployment number? Well, real is pretty subjective, but if you add up all the unemployed people who want to work but aren't looking, plus all the people who have given up, plus all the people working part-time even though they want to work full-time, you get a much higher number. In October, the regular unemployment rate was 7.3%, but that broader measure was 13.8%, almost twice as big as the regular unemployment figure.